Good morning students, welcome to Adhiman online class, Adhiman Matric Air Secondary School, Othangarai. Today we are going to discuss about taxonomic hierarchy. There are seven categories there in taxonomic hierarchy. What are the seven categories? That is the kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. These are the seven categories in taxonomic hierarchy. Okay. Some intermediate categories also there. What are they? It is called subkingdom, grade, division, subdivision, subphylum, superclass, subclass, suborder, superorder, superfamily, subfamily. These categories are intermediate categories are comes in between these seven main categories. For example, subkingdom, kingdom after the subkingdom comes. For example, we see the superfamily. It comes above the family. For example, subfamily, it comes below the family. So this is the intermediate categories. So let us see the seven categories one by one. First of all, we see the PCS. For example, PCS, I tell you two examples, lion and tiger. What is mean by the PCS? PCS is nothing but a group of animal having similar character, but they are reproductively isolated. But it's mating within themselves only and producing a fertile offspring. For example, lion mating with themselves lion only, tiger mating with themselves only, not tiger or lion mating themselves. So this is called the PCS. So they are always producing only a fertile offspring, but some exceptions are there. A close related PCS or interbreeding, what it will produce a sterile offspring. I tell you example for that. First one, we see the male horse crash with a female donkey producing a hinny. This is a sterile animal. It is unable to reproduce. Second one, male donkey crash with a female horse produce a mule. It is also a sterile animal. Then male lion crash with a female tiger. It produces the liger. It is also sterile. It is unable to produce or unable to produce the offspring. Next one is the male tiger crash with the female lion produce a tigon. It is also a sterile animal which is unable to reproduce the new offspring. These are the some exceptions. Close related PCS interbreeding may not be produce the offspring, but PCS alone only producing the offspring. This is the first category of the taxonomic hierarchy. This is a basic category is called the PCS. Next, one more steps go on above the PCS, then higher taxonomic hierarchy is called the genus. You know, genus is nothing but one or more close related PCS placed under the genus. That is called the genus. In the genus, there are two types there. One is called monotypic, another is called polytypic genus. What is mean by monotypic genus? The monotypic genus having for example of monotypic genus, Aldrus. It has only one PCS, example Red Panda. So only one PCS are there in a genus, that is called monotypic genus. But polytypic genus, there are many pieces are there, that is called polytypic genus. For example, Felis is the polytypic genus. In Felis genus, see, there is there are three more pieces are there. One is called Felis domestica, it is called domestic cat. Next is called Felis margarita, is called the jungle cat. Next is called the Felis silveridis, is called wild cat. So there are three pieces are there in one genus, that is called Felis. Oh, this is called as a polytypic genus. Okay, so many pieces put under the genus. The next higher category after the genus is called family. No, many close related genus are placed in the one family. For example, we take the one of the example of the family Pelidae. Pelidae is consisting all mammal groups. For example, in Pelidae, there are two genus are there. One is called Felis, another one is called Panthera. The Felis almost consisting the cat family, cat groups. Then Panthera consisting lion, tiger, leopard. And these two genus, Felis genus and Panthera genus put into the family is called Pelidae, the family Pelidae. So in one or more genus put in the family Pelidae. Next higher category, we see the order. There are one or more close families are put into the order. For example, here one order is called carnivora. You know, carnivora means flesh eating animal. In this, there are two families is that. One is called Canidae, another one is called Felidae. Canidae means dog and a fox. Felidia means what is called tiger, cat, like that. Okay, and these two families are put in the order. That order is called the carnivora. Next one is the class. See, one or more close related order put into the class. For example, we are the class mammalia. Okay, in this mammalia class, there are two order is there. One is called primata and carnivora. The primata is order nothing but herb, monkey, man, like that. Carnivora is not carnivorous animal, lion, cat, etc. But these two orders are placed in the one class that is called mammalia. Why these two orders put in the mammalia? Mammalia is nothing but a mammals, that is a milk-giving animals. There is a mammary glands are there. Based on the character, these two orders placed in this class. Because primata also having the mammary gland, carnivorous animal, lion, cat also mammary gland. So these two orders are put in the class mammalia. Okay. Then last one we see the phylum and many classes. Okay, for example, close related classes are put into the phylum, one phylum. Okay, for example, I quoted one example of the phylum is called Chordata. In this Chordata, there are so many classes are there. What are that? Is a fishes. Fishes means fish. Then Amphibia, example frog, living both water and land. Then Reptilia, that is a land creeping animals. Then next house, a flying birds. The next mammals, cow, dog, etc. These are all the class put in the phylum Chordata. Why means this? These all classes are put in the Chordata. Mainly one general character. They have the vertebral column or notochord and tubular nerve cord. As this character, all these classes are put in the phylum Chordata. Okay. The last one, highest most of category, taxonomy category is the kingdom. In kingdom is a topmost taxonomic in phylum. All phylums, okay, put in this kingdom. That means including all animals are put in this kingdom. So this is the taxonomic hierarchy. Let us sum up this one. First of all, is species. Is a species is nothing but a morphological character producing offsprings. So two or more pieces put into the genus. Then many genus are put in the family. And one or more families are put in the order. And one or more order put in the class. And one or more class put in the phylum. Then all phylum come in the kingdoms. But you see the one taxonomy to another taxonomic categories. We are going to that time. We be some genus having a similar character then only put in the one family. Some similar character families are put in the one order. Some similar character orders are put in the one class. And similar character classes are put in the one phylums. Then all the phylums come into the kingdom. So this is called the taxonomic hierarchy. Like this, any animal we are going to be classified. So like these animals are classified according to this taxonomic hierarchy, we are easily study and understand. Thank you. Have a nice study. See you the next session, students. Thank you very much.